Hi everyone, my name is Sarah from Hodos Training, and today we will talk about phone etiquette for business. And we will concentrate on customer satisfaction especially. So phone conversation is part of our everyday life. And even if we have text messages, emails, or social media to interact with other people, phone conversation is a very efficient way to pass on a message. So first of all, I would like you to do this Mentimeter survey that I prepared for you. So if you go to menti.com and you enter the code, you can access the Mentimeter survey and vote. In the meantime, I will share my screen so you can see the results from everyone.
Where is the code, Sarah?
So the code is in the chat. It's 5436. 482. You can all see the results. Has everybody voted? Yeah, great. So I can see that being put on hold, it's what you find most irritating. Now, that's very interesting. I will stop sharing so I can show you something that I find out about being placed on hold. So we'll go to a little presentation now. I will just open it so you can all see it. Can you all see my screen, right?
Yeah.
So phone etiquette for business. Forcom did a recent study. So Forcom is a telecommunication company here in the UK. And they did this study about what people find most annoying while they are on the phone. So what they found out is that 43% don't like when they are talking to someone and that person is talking to someone else in the background. Number two, with 42%, they don't like being interrupted. Now, it's funny because 11% of professionals in the UK admitted to interrupt their customers to finish their sentence, maybe. So they interrupt their customers, 11%. Now, with 41%, people don't like when the other person is clearly distracted while they're talking. On the fourth place, we have being placed on hold, which is 39%. And 35% is people that don't like when they are talking to someone that is eating or drinking while speaking. Now, for four of them, it's very obvious why customers may be irritated because they have to do with bad manners, somebody talking and the other person is eating or drinking. It's clearly impolite. But for one of them, why customers are irritated, it's not so obvious. Can you just pop in the chat which one, according to you, it's the not so obvious one? Yes, exactly. So most of you put being placed on hold. Yeah, everybody's got the right answer. Let me tell you a story about that. So this happened last year when we could still go out and eat out in restaurants. And a friend of mine wanted to book a dinner at this very posh restaurant in Mayfair. He loves this restaurant, so he just called, hoping that they would have a table for him that evening. So he calls, and when the receptionist picks up, she doesn't even give him a proper greeting. She just says, good evening, let me put you on hold for a moment. And boom, my friend is on hold. He doesn't even know the reason. He has not been given the chance to even speak and say why he was calling, but as I said, he really liked this restaurant, so he holds on the phone. 5 minutes go by, even a bit more, I think, and he's listening to this horrible music. As Jerry said, she hates when the music goes on and you have to listen to this over and over again while you are on hold. And a minute on hold feels like ages. So imagine 5 or 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, my friend is very frustrated because nobody's picking up the call on the other side and it just hangs up. Can you tell me what he did next? So thumbs up if you think that he called back the restaurant to book, or thumbs down if you think he called another place to book dinner for that night. Yeah, everybody got it right. He called another restaurant. 19% of customers that hang up will hang up because they are being placed on hold. Not for too long, even a short hold, even 45 to 60 seconds could be too much for them. And they hang up. And this is a serious loss of business. Now, let's have a look at the risks. What are the risks of people hanging up on you? A lost new customer. So that customer might have been the first time he was calling the restaurant. Nobody picks up after 15 minutes. He just calls another restaurant. A returning customer might consider never coming back to your place. Lost referral opportunity. If somebody asks my friend, "Oh, have you been to that restaurant in Mayfair?" You will say, "Yes, don't go there. They will never pick up the phone if you want to make a booking." Why customers don't like being on hold? They don't know why they've been placed on hold. Like my friend, it's just, bam, on hold without any explanation. They don't know what you're doing while they are on hold. You might be doing something important, but for what they know, you could be having a cup of coffee. You could be checking your phone. Now, I'm not saying you're doing that, but that's what the customer thinks. You're just lazy and you don't want to pick up the call. And they don't know for how long they are placed on hold. And this is very important. You don't know for how long you have to wait on the phone. You might be discouraged after a few seconds. Why we put people on hold? Because it happens in everyday situations at work. The first reason is because we don't know the answer to the customer inquiry and we have to ask somebody else. At the reception where I used to work, receptionists would pick up the phone and we had many customers inquiring about our car park, which is something that the concierge usually takes care of. But the concierge was mostly busy and the customers were just inquiring about the daily rate at the car park or the hourly rate, something very easy to know. You don't have to transfer the call every time for these kind of inquiries. So the second reason is because we have to transfer customers to a different department. Maybe the customer needs the accounting department and we need to transfer the call because we are at reception. And the third reason is because we are busy doing something else. As I said before, we want to finish with an important task before going ahead and taking the call. I want to explore what we could do instead of putting customers on hold. And the first thing that we could do is be well-trained. So be able to answer general inquiries and know which department you can transfer customers to. Most of the times I got this myself. I used to call places and they said, "Oh, I'm sorry, we don't take care of this. Let me transfer you to this department." Being on hold for some time and then talking to another person. "Oh, I'm sorry, it's the other department that takes care of this inquiry." So be well trained, know who to transfer your calls to and know about the general customer inquiries. We could engage in a genuine conversation with the customers. So instead of putting people on hold, let's say that is a customer calling a hotel, just ask them, "Have you been with us before?" If they are coming to the hotel, ask them the reason why they are coming. You may find out important information and take this opportunity to delight your customers later on. And we could also explain our customer what we are doing to address their inquiry. So they know that we are there to help them to really take care of their inquiry. Now, just to wrap up everything, I just wanted to recap what we went through this presentation. So we've seen what customers find most irritating when over the phone, why we have to put customers on hold, and what we could do instead. I want to leave you with 5 tips, and I would really like for you to take at least one of them and start practicing every day at work. So when talking over the phone, the most important things are: have a clear tone of voice. Don't speak too loud, don't speak too low. Avoid putting customers on hold if it's not strictly necessary. Be trained, so be able to answer most general questions that you get from your customers. Find out more about your customers in a genuine way, because our customers can feel when we are not being genuine, especially over the phone. And the last one is, if you have to put customers on hold, please explain them why. They will appreciate it and also ask for permission before doing so.